My name's Jonathan Faber, and these two paintings here are my work. I try to sort of set up juxtapositions to take place in them, where you kind of go back and forth between intimate space and vast space simultaneously. Areas like this, where you've got these elongated rectangles that are vertical, could be perceived as a space that is dark and deep that you might be penetrating into, while this could be considered like a very light wall that's flooded with a lot of light, while simultaneously it could be perceived as being a dark wall that's in shadow and you're looking into a much broader, vaster field. I play around and invent a lot of light or use my imagination in a way to kind of tweak light to do things that I want it to do. And I guess what I really want color to do in these paintings is I want it to impose a sense of weight and gravity to it while simultaneously generating atmosphere. The tube shapes, I like to think about them in terms of light tubes, like they might be something, you know, in the ceiling. But I also think about them as something that's moving. So I'll use effects such as blurring to make it feel like this is like almost like a comet traversing across this plane and getting ready to impact into this field here, where you're not quite sure what's going to happen, whether it's going to completely obliterate or just stop short. You know, in this one, same sort of thing. This blurring kind of creates a sense that it's kind of pulsating or pushing these two ends to either side of the canvas. This one obviously is starting to protrude into that space. This, I think, in terms of where it comes in along the lower portions of these fields, sort of reminds me of like that it could be a possibility to look across that. Like it's almost like you're looking across the landscape.
Like a horizon.
Right, like a horizon line. But then at the same time, I'll set up something down below that might be reminiscent of a reflection or something, so that it throws you off a little bit, jars you, or makes you think about it in from a couple of different angles. Prior to these, I was painting interior spaces from ground level, from the floor. I would take chair legs, casters, anything that was kind of filtering in, and expand them up to a scale that would be equal to your size. One of the paintings was about 6 feet by 10 feet. Out of that, I started to edit down a lot of that information and started to get to what I was perceiving as being what I truly was interested in, which was just light, space, and movement. Where it's going, I think it's just going to be getting, I'm going to keep kind of working on that particular theme, but trying to figure out ways to make it more complex in terms of how you perceive it.